In today's video, we're going to create this super slow motion shot you just saw. And we're not going to use any fancy camera like a phantom camera that can shoot 1,000 frames per second, because those are pretty expensive. And all we are having are the Blackmagic Pocket Cinema Camera, which are shooting in a way lower frame rate than 1,000 frames, but we're going to crank that all the way up and shoot in the highest possible frame rates available on the pocket camera. And then we are going to shoot that in the studio, and then we'll take it into DaVinci Resolve, and we're going to play around with some of the settings in optical flow, which are a nice addition to DaVinci Resolve, and we're going to try to see if we can create this super slow motion shot. What are the downsides of doing it that way? And can we kind of fake it without this super high speed slow motion camera? That's what this video is going to be all about. So without further ado, let's jump out in the studio and start to shoot. So first off, we're going to have a look at the clip here in different frame rates. For instance, here we're going to see the shot in 24 frames a second. Here we're going to see it in 60 frames a second. And lastly, we're going to see it at 120 frames a second. And that isn't really that slow, but we are going to slow that down. So in DaVinci Resolve, we're going to take this clip right here. And this clip is, as you see, in a 24 frames timeline. And if I right click and I go to clip attributes, we can see that this is 120 frames a second. So if we change this into 24 frames a second, because that is my timeline, okay, we're going to make this a little larger because it has now made this a pretty long clip. Let's go here, like so. And you'll see now that I've taken the clip and made that to 24 frames a second in 24 frames a second timeline. And this is going to slow down the footage, as you see right here. So this is just the clip out of the camera with that little conversion of the frame rates done in DaVinci Resolve. And as we can see right here, it is slow, but of course not super slow. And we're going to make this a super slow mo clip. So how do we do that? Okay, so I'm going to select the clip here and I'll go up to the inspector and I'll go down to speed change. And in this case, I'm going to change this. We can try some different stuff. So let's take this down to, let's say half the time, 50%, like that. And if we just play it now at a 50%, you can see it is pretty choppy and it isn't that's slow either. So we can still do something, at least we can do something with the choppiness. And also think we could slow this a little more down. So let's go down to 25%. It's going to enlarge the clip just a little bit. So now we have it at 25%. And it is very, very choppy, as you see, because we simply are missing a lot of frames. However, we can do something about that, because if we go into the real time and scaling, we can use the real time process. And in this case, we can use optical flow, and optical flow are just going to make different frames or add in frames where there are missing frames. So this is how it looks with optical flow applied. And there is still a lot of artifacts and stuff like that. However, we can actually change this and make it look better as well. If we go into the motion estimation here, we have some different options. So we could, for instance, try out Enhance Better, because Enhance Better are going to take off these wobbly effects a little bit. Some of them are still there, but it's, in some cases, this is passable. However, if you want the best result, you would have to go in and change the motion estimation into speed warp. Speed warp is super cool in DaVinci Resolve. However, if you see, even on my overspec Mac, I can't run this real time. It is just doing 1.5 frames a second at best. So the thing to do here would be either to
let it render out, and that is the red bar you see here. When that is turning into a blue bar, it's rendered out. Or you could go down to the select the clip, right click, and simply just render in place. And then you are going to do a rendered version of that, and that can take a bit of time as well. So I would recommend that you just make yourself a cup of coffee while rendering. And basically, that is how you can create slow motion inside of DaVinci Resolve, super fast, super easy. However, you have to be very careful with the percentage you can do things in. 25 is, I think, the slowest you can go. If you start to go below that, the results are not going to be very good at all. And of course, the effect is also kind of limited to the amount of frames you can shoot in per second. If you have the ability to shoot more than 220, please do that. If you can shoot in 300, lovely. But my cameras can't do that. So I'm stuck at 120 frames a second on the Blackmagic cameras I own. And then it's just a matter of adding in a speed ramp effect in the clip. So it'll go from normal speed to super slow to back to normal speed, like I did in the opening in the beginning of the video. Anyway, I do hope you found this little video useful. If you did, please hit that subscriber button, give the video a like, share it with your friends if you think it would help them out. And if you want to be notified every time there's a new video on this channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.